Thank you so much. We are joined now by a man who in 1984 was named Mr. Bookstore for his prowess on the bookstore basketball courts. He's a Notre Dame alum who's had a distinguished career serving others, from running the Center for the Homeless here in South Bend to leading Notre Dame's university relations team, which includes the world's greatest alumni association and the university's development organization, Mr. Lou Nani. And Lou, I'd like to say, when I come back to Notre Dame and participate in this event, the first thing I do is I see your smiling face and Jim Small's smiling face. Yeah. So we always love coming back and seeing you and giving back to the university. Did you ever foresee that this celebration, this broadcast, would grow into what it has become?
Well, first of all, Justine, thank you for coming back. This is your third year back, coming out of New York to host this, and you and Vic and so many others doing this completely voluntarily in support of your alma mater, the crew, everybody else. We are so blessed that so many people care about this place. And no, to answer your question, I didn't, in my wildest imagination, didn't think that we'd be where we are today. We just got in hot off the press that last year's broadcast won the 2016 For Rome International Web Awards.
Incredible.
For the best nonfiction reality and best directing nonfiction reality, all the way down. And that's a tribute to you guys. I mean, you make this work, and Jim Small and our team helps to coordinate things with his group, but we're really, really blessed, and that so many people care about Notre Dame to come back here and make Notre Dame special, Notre Dame Day so special.
And we really showcase the Notre Dame community in what it's all about and the values of this university.
Correct. Inspiring stories, fun stories, and I think a lot that informs you of what's going on around this place that really makes an impact on the world.
And you have another project on your plate, a very busy man. It's coming up in August. It's a Notre Dame Trail. So that is something I haven't heard much about.
Right.
So what is that all about?
So I don't know that any school is stupid enough to undertake an adventure like this, but Father Soren, in 175 years ago, in 1842, walked from southern Indiana with seven Holy Cross brothers, $300 in their pocket, to found the University of Notre Dame du Lac. And they walked over 300 miles following the old buffalo trails and the Native American trails to establish this university. So we're going to recreate that pilgrimage. And we're going to invite members of the Notre Dame family to walk with us in different increments. The last 5 days, there'll be a core group that will walk the whole 13 days.
Okay.
But the last 5 days, the last 3 days, or the very last day. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be an incredible celebration. Let me tell you why we're doing it. Because it's really important, before you think about where you want to go as an institution or as a person, you better understand where you've come from. And we think that where we've come from, in fact, informs where we're going. And so we want to make sure we haven't forgotten our roots. And that's what this is about. It's about embracing our roots as a university, as a Notre Dame family, but also inviting anybody in the Notre Dame family or beyond to participate in a pilgrimage, an ancient church tradition that has been largely lost in this country, where you can walk and reflect and pause and pray and think about your life and think about, you know, what you'd like to do going forward.
Too.
Exactly. So we're really excited about it. We hope to have 10,000 people walking with us this summer.
I can picture it. That's an incredible image.
Yeah. So I don't think any other school would be foolish enough, foolhardy
enough.
Well,
and any other school, you all just produced 29 hours of mostly live.
Yep.
Then you have the Notre Dame Trail, but you also have a play that you're working on. So
exactly.
Got a lot of projects, Lou.
So, you know, Patrick Vassell, who was just here, the associate director of the Broadway hit Hamilton, and he just brought two of the stars of the show here with him. He's directing this play. Christina Gorman is the playwright, a 91 grad, whose son is currently a freshman at Notre Dame. And this is an amazing narrative of Father Soren reflecting on the building of Notre Dame. And it's going to be spectacular. We've seen some clips of it already. They're finalizing it, and we're going to begin to share that and roll that out in 17 fall, and then 18 with a broader Notre Dame family. We're really excited about it.
And we also, Lou, we want to take a minute to talk about Father Ted Hesburgh. He would have celebrated his 100th birthday in a couple weeks. What is your favorite memory or favorite story of yours in regards to Father Ted?
Father Ted was, you know, I still think for so many of us, a father, a grandfather, somebody that we all had an intimate connection with. One of the stories that I love the most is Jimmy Dunn, one of our Notre Dame trustees and the chair of this latest campaign, tells a story. He was playing in a golf tournament out in Northern California, and this Fortune 50 CEO wanted to meet up with him. And Jimmy was, you know, that New York kind of mentality kind of evading him a little bit, and finally he caught up, and Jimmy said, I wanted to know what he wanted of me. Did he want 50-yard line tickets or whatever? And he finally met up with Jimmy, and he said, Jimmy, I just want to tell you a story. I want to tell you a story about your president, Father Ted Hesburgh. See, my uncle in the 1950s, shortly after Father Ted became president, was tragically killed in an accident on campus during his sophomore year. And I just want to let you know that for 40 consecutive years, your president, Father Ted, wrote a handwritten letter to my mother every day on the anniversary of her death. And my father assured me that it was that letter that kept her alive for the last 10 years of her life. Scandal, by definition, is public. Holiness is often hidden or seeks to hide itself. The great thing about being part of the Notre Dame family isn't just to call us to greatness, to boldness, but also to holiness, to do little things, quiet things that nobody knows of, gestures that make a difference. And that's maybe my favorite Father Ted story.
He's touched so many.
Yeah.
He's touched so many.
I agree.
And so have you, Lou. Thank you for all that you do for this university, truly.
Thank you. We're close. This last hour, any area of interest at the university that hits the most votes in this last hour gets an additional $1,000 toward their student group or whatever it's about. But Justine, again, you and everybody, our heartfelt
thanks. And the production crew who's been here since 5 a.m.
Amazing. We're so blessed.
If you can't tell, we love Notre Dame.
Yeah,
so Vic, we know you're in that company too.
Thank you, Vic.